breaking news right now on the search for truth about January 6th and a last resort legal challenge from the former president. Just moments ago, Donald Trump filed this with a federal court, asking an appeals court to stop him, the requirement that he turn over sensitive presidential records to the House committee investigating the January 6th insurrection. That, after late Wednesday, the former president lost again in U.S. District Court. Let's get straight to CNN's Paula Reid, who's tracking these developments for us. Paula, what's the latest?
Well, John, just moments ago, Trump asked the Court of Appeals in D.C. to delay the handover of his White House records to lawmakers while he appeals a decision by a lower court that would allow the House Select Committee investigating the insurrection to access some of his records related to January 6th. Now, so far, it hasn't been going very well for Trump in court. Twice in the past roughly 48 hours, Judge Tanya Chutkan ruled against Trump in his quest to keep his White House records from the House Select Committee. On Tuesday, Chutkan ruled on the overall case that as a former president, she says that Trump does not have the power to keep records secret when the current president supports their release. Now, after that decision, Trump asked her to buy him some time before his records were handed over so he could appeal her decision. Now, not surprisingly, Chutkan would not grant that delay of her own decision, but as a procedural matter, he had to ask her first before moving up the ladder to a higher court, which is exactly what he did in this motion. Now, as of right now, the National Archives, which inherited Trump's records after he left office, will begin handing over some of these disputed records on Friday unless a court orders a delay. Now, John, whoever loses at the appellate level will likely ask the Supreme Court to take up this case. So a lot riding for Trump and the committee on this.
A lot, I would say a lot riding in the search for the truth as well. Paula Reid, grateful for the hustle on the breaking news with me in studio to share their reporting and their insights. Margaret Talov of Axios, Nolan McCaskill of the Los Angeles Times, Politico's Laura Brown Lopez, and CNN legal analyst Kerry Cordero. Kerry, let me start with you. You were reading through the brief. Does the former president have much of a case to make as he now goes up to the appeals court level?
Not according to the district court judge. As Paula was describing, the district court judge rejected his argument for an injunction, and she really notes that he doesn't have any new arguments. When I look through this new brief that he has before the appellate court, there are no new arguments that he's making. He's just relying on the same old arguments. And what really comes across is that his team continues to argue as if he were still the president. They still consider that he's making arguments that the disclosure of the documents are not in the public interest, whereas the district court said that disclosure is what is in the public interest, and that's what the current president Biden has said, is that disclosure is in the public interest. So there's this disagreement between the Trump team saying this case, what they say in their brief, presents weighty and rarely litigated constitutional issues that could have a profound effect on the executive branch, but the actual executive branch is saying not really.
Right. And they are rarely litigated, but they have it just because you don't normally have these big investigations involving presidents. But there has been one. Let's go back to 1977, Nixon versus the GSA, which is a similar case. The Supreme Court said the privilege is not for the benefit of the president as an individual, but for the benefit of the republic, which gets you to the point. If the Trump team keeps arguing up, they're at the appeals court level now, the Supreme Court level would be next. Will it get there? Is it almost guaranteed to get there? Or can the appeals court essentially shut it down in a way that keeps it from the high court?
I think the appeals court has a basis based on what the district court judge has written in her opinions, has a sound basis to reject his appeal. He could then appeal that again. I mean, he has an ability to have his case heard, but the courts don't have to continue to entertain these arguments from a private individual about matters that the current executive has already weighed in on. As the district court judge said in one of her early opinions, she said, presidents are not kings and plaintiff is not president. And that's really the key in this.
And this happens to be fact as well. Nolan, when you get to Capitol Hill, this committee, you know, has been worried that this would take forever. The committee's trying to search for the truth. It's trying to have hearings. It wants the witnesses. It wants the documents. And it knows what the courts say about Donald Trump will have a domino effect on all of the other people who come forward before it. I assume the committee has to be happy right now, thinking as soon as tomorrow they might start to see some of these records.
Right. I mean, I think they would certainly love to have these records as soon as possible. Just thinking about this whole entire situation earlier, I feel like it's actually against Donald Trump's interest to try to delay the documents. Now, when I was talking to people who were being interviewed to potentially work for the committee, they were telling me that the committee was telling them that they wanted to wrap up around maybe March of next year. You know, you had House Republicans basically delay the formation of the committee, which wasted some time. So if Donald Trump is able to successfully delay this, he could sort of end up in a situation where House Democrats on this committee are releasing information about January 6th and say August, September, October, really close to an election, which could have a huge impact on a race. And so that being said, I don't think it's in Donald Trump's best interest to try to delay this. I mean, it is in his character to be a fighter and to fight for this, but I think that it could end up harming House Republicans if he is successful.
Politically, and as Kerry notes, they continue to refer to Donald Trump in here as if he's the active president. That's the keeping the audience of one happy. As you go through this, again, Donald Trump is exhibit A in the legal fight. Does he have privilege? Does he have to turn over these documents? But so many of his allies have refused subpoenas.
Yep.
And so what the courts say here will have a domino effect down the line. Among them is Steve Bannon, who is still out on the road, still talking to Republican groups and still saying this.
In 2020, Donald Trump won a bigger victory in this country. And I will debate any person, take on any presidential commission, go before Congress, do anything they want, and show them the receipts starting here in Arizona. Here's the beauty of Trump. He'll be the only one in American history to win the presidency three times.
That is more evidence in the greatest fraud in American political history, which is the lies they continue to tell their own supporters. Steve Bannon, I'll go before any committee. He defied a subpoena.
Right.
The committee wanted him to come in and tell the truth. Mm-hmm. If you'll go before anybody and make your case, why won't Steve Bannon show up before Congress and answer the questions?
Right, and whether or not the DOJ charges him with criminal contempt is what all of those other Trump allies or Trump the aides that are in Trump's inner circle, as high level as Stephen Miller, as you know, the former press secretary Kayleigh McEnany, and even some low level aides there. All of them are looking to see whether or not the DOJ charges Bannon, because if they don't follow through on that, then they're going to think that they can also defy these subpoenas. There's now 16 subpoenas out or so.
Right.
That's roughly the level that the January 6th committee issued this week. And that is a huge question about whether or not this committee gets to the truth, gets to the bottom of not just what the communication around January 6th itself, but also what influence there was in the outcome of the election and counting votes and attempts to try to stop the count.
Yeah, I just think the bottom line is underneath all these legal arguments in today's response are two truths. The former president does not want to turn over any documents to anybody and wants as little transparency as possible around the inner workings of decisions that would be documented there. And two, has an extreme interest in delaying this as long as possible, and so does everybody else down the chain.
Joining us to discuss, Kim Whaley, law professor at the University of Baltimore, former assistant U.S. attorney, and author of How to Read the Constitution and Why. So, Kim, back to this new filing from Trump and his team asking for the Court of Appeals to put a pause on this, you know, tranche of documents that are set to be released tomorrow to the committee. Walk us through what happens next. And do you think this court will grant Trump this emergency stay?
Well, what's interesting, Anna, this is almost a motion for an injunction on an injunction. This is a pretty rare move, what was filed today. That is, they already have settled for potentially expedited briefing the question of the big injunction. That is, should they stay what the disclosure of the documents pending a resolution of whether Donald Trump has this authority? And then they ask for a mini stay pending that discussion. So what they indicate in the papers is that the other side, Congress, has not taken a position on it. So Congress isn't pushing back and saying this is harming us by waiting. So my guess is the Court of Appeals might just grant it just for the sake of, you know, everybody getting along. But I think the arguments on the merits that this is preliminary relief that Donald Trump has, he has to show that he's likely to win. And at the end of the day, this is a duel between a sitting president and a former president. He's essentially arguing that his rights as a former president supersede Joe Biden's rights as a sitting president when it comes to executive privilege. The problem with that is that these aren't his personal records. These are his official government records. They belong to the people under the Presidential Records Act. And Joe Biden in this moment is a representative of the people under the Constitution, not Donald Trump. So I think ultimately he's going to lose. The question is, will the delay be enough to basically thwart the January 6th commission's work until the midterms, when I think the Republicans hope to take over the House and cancel the entire process?